It's fantastic to get out on site, as well as being joined by Joe today. I'm here to see Matt from MJ Electrical Services, who's wired the wonderful properties around us.
Absolutely, and you may remember seeing Matt on a previous couple of videos that we made, one where we installed a Tesla charger, which was really interesting, and also an AFDD board, which we enjoyed greatly as well. But in this video, we're going to be installing and reviewing the Debox connectors range from Hylec. So I think it's about time we got inside and had a look at what we're doing in this video.
If we're going inside, time to put the tea on.
So we've managed to nip inside now, and we've come into the only room in the entire property that has a heater. And we're here with Harry, who's been working for MJ Electrical, and he's actually been running this entire site of four properties, looking after the electrical installation. How are you doing today, Harry?
I'm all good.
Good.
Thank you very much.
Excellent. Yeah. And what are we going to be fitting in this first segment here?
We're going to be fitting the Hylec Debox S.
Yep.
On this spotlight.
Excellent. And of course, this is the first of a few different types of this junction box that we're going to be installing.
Yep.
And what are the connections like inside there? What have we got in there?
We've just got a four-way connector block.
Excellent. So this is the screwed type.
Yeah.
Excellent. Very good. And of course, a perfect situation because we can terminate the cables into that junction box, pop it up into the ceiling, and fit the spotlight or away. Good stuff. Excellent. Let's crack on. So obviously we're just stripping the cables here then, Harry, so using the mechanical strippers there, not favouring the knife or the side cutters method.
No, it's a lot quicker and easier.
It's good.
I find.
Yeah. I always like how it gives that nice clean finish on the end of the sheet there as well.
It definitely does.
Definitely didn't go for the cheese cutting method where you pull the CPC through the insulation, because no doubt we would be getting comments if we did that. And I can't help but notice that you're using croppers there as well, rather than side cutters. So there seems to be an endless debate on social media about which is better. Why are you favouring the croppers there, Harry?
I just find them a lot easier to work with my hands, a lot easier to hold, and it's just what I'm used to.
Now, you've demonstrated another really nice, neat little feature of the Debox S there, Harry, because you've taken the connector out of the box, which is really good, because it means that you're not kind of faffing about with the box in the way. You can just get that out, get the conductors terminated into it, and you're ready to go, which is really nice. Making sure that we hadn't nicked that copper so it didn't snap when it went into the terminal. Excellent. And we've got a four-way block in there, which is obviously helpful if perhaps you're using a loop-in method of the wiring at this point. You know, maybe if this is the first one, we've got four down lights in this room, and if we'd brought the permanent line neutral to the first light fitting and then down to the switch, that'd be handy. Looks like these are wired with the line in neutral at the switch, though, in this case, is that right? So you're not worrying about the too many cables, which is good. Let's get that properly wrapped. You're settling into this now, aren't you, Harry? Getting a lot more comfortable now being on camera.
Just trying to ignore the camera.
It's difficult because, from my point of view, it's kind of between you and your work, so you're doing very well if you can do that, yeah.
So I'm happy they're all secure, always worth giving them a quick tug to make sure they're in place.
Top tip, very good. And then that just pushes back onto that little nib there.
Yeah, and make sure they're flat.
Very good. Nice. And then when you close that clamp up, I noticed there's no screw on there. Is that helpful, not having a screw on the clamp?
It's one less thing, so time-wise, it's better. But you do need to check that obviously they are secure.
Yeah, make sure it's gripping down on there. Yeah.
So what we'll do, we'll now get the spotlight.
Excellent, so we're putting in the connections for the spotlight now for the recess down.
Bent into place for easy fitting.
Very nice, very nice.
You obviously clamp down with your thumb to make sure they stay in place.
Excellent. And again, it's nice and adaptable, this box, isn't it? Because, you know, you could have, you've got two different kinds of cable coming in and out, a different number on each side, and that cable grip again, that's going to clamp down to different thicknesses of cable, which is really helpful.
And obviously, again, check for tightness.
Yeah, so we've got three clicks on that one, and that's got that nice and tight. Really good. And again, when you close up the outside, really nice is that you've got, it just clips closed, doesn't it? So you've not got a tool again to worry about.
And then we've got the lock-in
pin. Good. Just for that extra bit of security. Now, obviously this isn't a maintenance-free connector because it's got the screw terminals. But perfectly suitable for the situation that we're installing here. Nice work. Now we're installing pretty much the exact same enclosure here, Harry, but what's different about what's inside the enclosure this time?
These are push-fit connectors.
Excellent. And we love a push-fit connection because, again, it takes that one extra bit of work out of the process. And what about getting them out? Because obviously it's a bit of a nightmare with these terminals, isn't it, when you want to remove them?
With the push.
Oh, nice.
And they straight
just
out.
Yeah, just whip out like that. Lovely. Really good. Excellent. So again, we're sort of heading closer to a bit of a maintenance-free connection here, aren't we? With the push-fit terminals, the screwless, which is good. And once we've got those conductors in there, we're actually in the exact same position that we were a moment ago, where it's just a matter of getting those cables into the cord grip. And now we'll make the connection for the spotlight. And again, just a slightly different connection method here, Harry. So what you're having to do to get these ones
in? Push down the button instead of just straight in. So we need to push that to open up the connector to get, obviously, the conductor in.
Very good. And of course, we've got a flexible conductor here instead. And they've got ferrules on the end there. But if they didn't have, that terminal would accommodate it anyway. So it's not a problem. Excellent. Now, just before we move on from here, if we look in the lid of the box here, you can see there's two kind of little circular indents there, and of course if we were installing this onto a surface with the cables running in and out, we'd be using those for fixing purposes, wouldn't we? So you'd screw that bit down and then close the lid over, and again you've got that lovely enclosed connection. So we'll box that one up, and that's another one done.
So we'll keep the connectors fitted into the box.
Excellent. Now I noticed that we're on the end of the circuit here, Harry, so we've got the last cable, so we're down to just one cable. So what's the sort of advantage of the box that you're installing here?
It's a lot smaller, so we can always use that for obviously smaller holes in the ceiling, so more decorative light.
Oh, brilliant,
So it means that obviously we can fit these straight up, but the only thing will be is obviously two cables going in.
Yeah.
Could be more difficult to use the smaller box for single cables.
Yeah, very good. So again, you know, you don't need to waste that larger box where you've only got one cable coming in. Obviously it will accommodate a couple of cables, which is really good. So that's really good. So this is the Hylec Debox SM. So this is the smaller version with the screwed connectors again. And like you say, you know, perfect for where you've just got the one cable, might as well use it for that. And also, as you said, sometimes you get those really small spotlights that have the tiny cutout holes in, and trying to get a larger junction box in. Those electricians of a certain age will remember the old round brown junction boxes, and you had to sort of cut a slot into the ceiling to get them through a tiny hole. Well, we've not got that problem here, which is really good. So just finish those terminations off, and again we've got all the same features that we had before, which is brilliant. Use of tools is minimized, and we've also got the cord grips, which will clamp down onto various sizes of conductor and cable as well. It'll even accommodate round flexes as well, which is really good. That's a nice feature as well, if that's what you're using to go out to your spotlight. Snaps up. And we noticed in the cable entries earlier, you've got a little kind of slit in the entry part, which just adapts itself around the cables that you're installing, which is handy. And pop the little retaining pin in, keep that lid securely closed. Nice, neat little connection that. Okay, so we're moving on to our final joint box now, and this is which connection box here, Harry?
It's the Debox SL2.
Nice, very good. So the major difference in this one, of course, is that we've got these lever-style connectors in here, which obviously we love a lever-style connector here at eFIXX because they make electricians' lives easier. And of course, this is one of the things that's going to help to make this connection box maintenance-free. And of course, this style of connector can be used in a couple of different ways. You can lift the lever up, as you demonstrated there, Harry, and put the conductors in and then close the levers down, and that grips on there. But of course you can also just use them directly by pushing them in without having to mess around with the lever at all, which is really good. So you can literally just push them straight in there. Very good. And that's the connection made nice and simple. Very good. So again, showing the versatility of the box here is nice as well, because we can actually take those connectors out of the box and install them separately, as we're doing here. Or you can leave them in the box and just use that push-in facility if you want, which is handy.
Obviously, we make sure the conductors are to the end.
Very nice.
Which we can see them.
And again, at this point, because we're on the flexible conductor, it's a little bit easier to use the lever function on here. And of course, we're only using three of the connections in this case, because it's probably a little bit overkill for this application here, but it's a nice demonstration of what it can do. And what we're gonna have a think about as well is that you don't just have those three connector blocks inside here, you've actually got five connector blocks. So we could do a three plate light fit in here quite easily and have a spare terminal as well. perhaps if we've got a couple of switch lives or something like that going on. And again, just to illustrate, it is a little bit overkill. These are actually 32 amp rated terminals, which is obviously a lot more than we need for a lighting circuit, which is good. And again, we've got this nice, it's a slightly different type of cable retention in this case, because we've got the cables just going into those grips there, so we're just pressing the cables into place. We don't have to push that little clicky thing down like we did earlier. Very good. And they're all nicely seated back in the relevant places. And because Harry's a nice chap, he's going to leave that connector block in there for the next person who comes along as well if they need it. And then once again, it's just a matter of closing it up. We've got the little ceiling pin, and actually, I don't know if we managed to catch that on the inside of the lid. There's actually a spare one of those as well, so that when you've opened it up, if that pin gets damaged, just there, got a spare pin for future reference as well, which is handy.
That seemed to disappear quite early on there, Gary. There's no sight of you during that video. What happened?
Spent a lot of time in that kitchen. I've had enough cup of teas to last me a week.
Absolutely. I'm sure you noticed in the kitchen around the rest of the house, all those spotlights, which were making the property look absolutely fantastic. And we also saw during this video that no matter what the connecting situation, the Hylec Debox range seems to provide a solution for that.
Yeah, and as always, we're interested in your feedback. Please leave those in the comments below, and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.